Welcome to Wisdom Trek with Gramps. Wisdom is the final frontier in gaining true knowledge. Our mission is to create a legacy of wisdom, to seek out discernment and insights, and to boldly grow where few have chosen to grow before. Hello, my friend. This is Gramps. Thanks for coming along on our trek to increase wisdom and create a living legacy. We are told in Proverbs chapter 16, verse 16, how much better to get wisdom than gold, and sound judgment than silver. Today is day 1609 of our trek, and it is time for another nugget of wisdom, which includes an inspirational quote, along with some wise words from Gramps for today's trek. If you apply the words that you hear today, over time, it will help you to become more healthy, wealthy, and wise as you continue on your daily trek of life. So let's jump right in with today's nugget. Today's quote is from Brian Tracy, and it is, "At least 80% of millionaires are self-made. That is, they start with nothing but ambition and energy, the same way most of us start." So today's lesson will be on nothing but ambition. While this quote is about financial success, the same applies to every area of our lives. Most people do not start in life with abundance of wealth, talents, abilities, intellect, or wisdom. All of these are gained by those who are willing to start with nothing. It is through perseverance, ambition, and energy over a long period of time, incrementally achieving until you are successful. Those who are eager to put their blood, sweat, and tears into action are those who end up being millionaires, successful in business, excellent in academic achievement, or whatever their calling is, making a significant impact on the world for God's kingdom. Not everyone has the same talents and abilities, but we all have some. God does not expect us to achieve in areas where He has not given us the abilities. God does expect us to use our talents and skills that He has given us thoroughly for His glory. You may become a millionaire or excel in a number of areas of your life, but it is not nearly as important as doing your very best with what God has given you. God does expect us to use what we have been given. It has been said that God does take care of the birds, but He doesn't throw the worms in the nest for them. They must use their natural abilities that God has given them to find the worms. I believe a parable from Jesus, which He told about a week before He was crucified, will sum up our nugget of wisdom for today. The parable is found in Matthew chapter 25, verses 14 through 30. Again, the kingdom of heaven can be illustrated by the story of a man going on a long trip. He called together his servants and entrusted his money to them while he was gone. He gave 5 bags of silver to one, 2 bags of silver to another, and 1 bag of silver to the last, dividing it in proportion to their abilities. He then left on his trip. The servant who received 5 bags of silver began to invest the money and earned 5 more. The servant who had 2 bags of silver also went to work and earned 2 more. But the servant who received 1 bag of silver dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. After a long time, their master returned from his trip and called them to give an account on how they had used the money. The servant who had been entrusted with 5 bags of silver came forward with 5 more and said, "Master, you gave me 5 bags of silver to invest. I have earned 5 more. The master was full of praise. "Well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful in handling this small amount. So now I will give you many more responsibilities. Let's celebrate together." The servant who had received 2 bags of silver came forward and said, "Master, you gave me 2 bags of silver to invest. I have earned 2 more. The master said, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful in handling this small amount, so now I give you many more responsibilities. Let's celebrate together." Then the servant with 1 bag of silver came and said, "Master, I knew you were a harsh man, harvesting crops you did not plant and gathering crops you didn't cultivate. I was afraid I would lose your money, so I hid it in the earth. Look, here's your money back." But the master replied, "You wicked and lazy servant, if you knew I harvested crops I didn't plant and gathered crops I didn't cultivate, why didn't you deposit my money in the bank? At least I could have gotten some interest on it." Then he ordered, "Take the money from this servant and give it to the one with 10 bags of silver. To those who use well what they are given, even more will be given, and they will have it in abundance. But from those who do nothing, even what little they have will be taken away. I'll throw this useless servant into the outer darkness, where there is weeping and gnashing of teeth." Now this is certainly a good lesson from Christ today. And as you ponder on this nugget of wisdom for yourself, I would ask you to please encourage your friends and family to join us and then come along with us on Monday for another day of Wisdom Trek, Creating a Legacy. If you'd like to listen to any of the past 1,608 treks or read the Wisdom Journal, they are all available at wisdom-trek.com. And I encourage you to subscribe to Wisdom Trek on your favorite podcast player so that each day will be downloaded to you automatically. And thank you so much for allowing me to be your guide, your mentor, but most importantly, I am your friend, as I serve you through the Wisdom Trek podcast and journal each day. And as we take this trek of life together, let us always live abundantly, love unconditionally, listen intentionally, learn continuously, lend to others generously, lead with integrity, and leave a living legacy each day. I am Guthrie Chamberlain, reminding you to keep moving forward, enjoy your journey, and create a great day every day. See you on Monday for more daily wisdom.